This is our last concept in this module. Often we are curious about how large of a sample we should use in order to get a reliable estimate of a population proportion. Here's a formula that could help us out. N equals z star times p hat times q hat, all divided by the margin of error squared. Now, just a note, this formula didn't just come out of thin air. It's actually our margin of error formula solved for n. So what they did is they took this guy and through the use of several algebra steps, they isolated n. So this formula is something we've already used, we're just using it in a different way. So if you know the kind of confidence you'd like to have for your estimate, how big of a margin of error you would like to have, and possibly a value for p hat and q hat, then we can figure out how large of a sample do you have to use. Here's an example. You've been hired by the Ford Motor Company to do market research, and you must estimate the percentage of households in which a vehicle is owned. How many households must you survey if you want to be 99% confident that your sample percentage has a margin of error of 3 percentage points? We're going to go ahead and assume that a previous study suggested that vehicles are owned in 86% of homes. So what we know so far is that we want 99% confidence for this, which means that our z star, our critical value, is going to be 2.575. They mentioned that they wanted their margin of error to be 3 percentage points, thus E will equal 0.03. And finally, we're assuming that we can use a prior study that found out that 86% of homes had a vehicle, so we'll let P hat be equal to 0.86 and Q hat, the complement, 0.14. So if we plug these values above into our sample size calculation formula, don't forget to square z star and e. Intermediate step here you can try with your calculator. See if you get the same thing. The value we discover for n is 887.03 households. Now we're going to do a weird sort of rounding here. Because we have 887.03 and households are considered discrete entities, in other words, I can't interview a fraction of a household, we are going to round up to the nearest whole number. Now I recognize that 0.03 is quite small, but the fact that this value went over 887 means that we need to interview 888 households. Now what this does is it gives us an insurance that we're going to keep the 99% confidence we started with, that our error is going to stay manageable and no larger than 3%. And of course, we want those to be insured because that's how you started your problem. So anytime you have any sort of decimal value here, no matter how large or how small, we always go up to the next largest whole number. Here's part B. Assume there's no available information that you can use to estimate the percentage of homes that have a car. So when there's no available information for your sample proportion, that is p hat, then we often take the route where we'll let p hat and q hat both equal 0.5. This will give us the most conservative estimate of size, which is actually the largest, that will allow us to have the type of confidence we want and the type of margin of error. So when you don't know a value for p hat, which is often the case, then we just share the load. Let p hat be a half and let q hat be a hat. Now we're just doing the same calculation as before. We're just now using 0.5 here and here. Here's an intermediate step if you want to check it with your calculator. Divide this out, and we find that n is equal to 1,841.5. 1.84. Like in the prior part A, we cannot interview a fraction of a household. So this 0.84, we're going to take this value again and round up to the next highest whole number. So you and your team would need to interview 1,842 households for this task. So you can see quite a few more than double, I believe, if I did the math right, than you would have to do if you didn't have a prior estimate for P hat and Q hat.